So hello and welcome back all of my dear students. So in today's video we are going to start our new chapter, that is natural regions. So what are these natural regions, what is the meaning of region and all these things, that is what we are going to discuss. Now if I want to give you an overview of what we are going to see or we are going to learn in this particular chapter, is that we will be looking at different types of human, animal, again natural vegetation, climate and all these different things that occur in different parts of our earth. So you might have sometime wondered that in Arctic region there are polar bears, but why don't they exist in our area? Okay, or in India, why don't we see polar bears in our region? So you see, there is a particular reason for this thing. Okay, so first of all I will explain you about region. Okay, what is region? Region. So region is nothing but a particular area of land which has a particular set of characteristics. Okay, that is what is called as a region. Then if I talk about desert and if I talk about Shimla, okay, you will quickly identify when I said desert, so you can link Rajasthan with that, and when I said Shimla, you can link that in Shimla there is frost or snowfall. So you see, why is such kind of difference in these different places? So the basic and the most important thing that you have to remember is that everything we see on our earth is due to the sun. Okay, what I just said, this is the most important term that you will this is linked with all of this life on our earth. Okay, living things, non-living things, everything is affected by the sun. That is why sun is a god for us. So sun is the major factor due to which everything exists on our earth. It may be water, it may be wind, it may be the different kind of things, like whatever, everything exists due to the sun only. What happens is that our earth is tilted at about 23.5 degrees. So due to this inclination of our earth, what happens is that there are different temperature zones that occur due to this tilt of the axis of our earth. So you see, in the previous year we have learnt about the temperate zone, again torrid zone and frigid zone. So this is going to help us in our today's lesson. So first of all, we have to learn how does the temperature different occurs in different part of our earth. I hope you know that the source of the temperature or the heat that the earth gets, it all comes from our sun. So you see, the position in which the sun will be perpendicular on our earth, that part will get the maximum amount of heat. And the another parts where the sun is not directly perpendicular, these parts will get small amount of heat. So I'll show you one photograph regarding that. So just see this thing, where you can see the maximum amount of perpendicular sun rays are falling. Okay, you can see it is falling in the middle part of the earth. Okay, so this middle part is between the Tropic of Cancer and the Tropic of Capricorn. I hope you know that our earth is tilted. So what happens is that when the amount of sun rays fall perpendicular on these places, this place absorb maximum amount of heat. And if we talk about the rest, the part above the Tropic of Cancer and the part below the Tropic of Cancer, you see, again we have divided it into few parts. That is what? The Arctic Circle, and below is the
Antarctic Circle. So you see, the part between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle, and the part between Tropic of Capricorn to the Antarctic Circle. So you see, these parts get a little bit less amount of heat as compared to the tropical region, okay, the equatorial and that region. So this is why on our entire Earth there will be medium range temperature in these areas between the Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn into the Antarctic Circle, okay. And lastly, you see there are polar regions on the both above the Arctic Circle and below the Antarctic Circle. So you see what happens over here is that the amount of sun rays that these places are getting, even they get the amount of sun rays for 6 complete months, but still there is ice on these places. Why? Because you see, these rays are very dispersed in the atmosphere over there, because you see the beam of sun rays whichever this area is getting, this is limited, and you see the space is more over there, space or let's say sky. So what happens, these beams of sunlight or the heat that comes around from over here, it gets scattered very easily on a large amount of the land or sky. So that is the reason that these places get a very less amount of sunlight per square kilometer. So that is why these polar regions, the North Pole and the South Pole, these regions are very cold in temperature. So I hope you noticed something. In between the tropics, it is highly temperature. Okay, it is highly temperate zone. Okay, not temperate zone, like I will tell you about it later on. This between the tropics, okay, area between the tropics have the highest amount of temperature all throughout the year. Then you see the areas between Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer and Antarctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn. This area have medium temperature. I told you in the beginning only. This areas have medium temperature. And the last part, that is above the Arctic Circle towards the North Pole and below the Antarctic Circle towards the South Pole. These areas, these have the most coldest area on our planet. Okay, that is the lowest temperature on our Earth. So can you notice some different pattern over here? The temperature goes on reducing as we go up and below the equatorial line. Okay, so notice this point, the temperature on our Earth reduces as we go away from equator towards to the poles. So that is the basic fundamental thing that you have to understand first of all. So as I told you, the zone between the Tropic of Cancer to Tropic of Capricorn, this has the highest amount of heat. So this area is called as tropical region, or also known as torrid zone. Okay, tropical region or torrid zone. Then again, the areas between Arctic Circle and Tropic of Cancer and Antarctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn, both of these areas have medium temperature. So these areas are called as temperate zones. Okay, temperate zones. Now don't get confused between tropical and temperate, or torrid also, because you see most of people get confused between what is a temperate zone, because you see the name suggests that it might be more temperature over there in that zone than the another places. So that's where people get confused between tropical and temperate zones. So you have to remember, temperate zone means the area between the Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle and the area between the Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle, which have medium temperature on our Earth. And then lastly is the area of Arctic Circle and above up to the North Pole, and the Antarctic Circle below that towards the South Pole. So these two regions are called as polar zones. Okay, polar zones or frigid zone. So frigid, I hope you know the meaning of frigid, that is completely freezed with solid ice. So these areas are like, when you look at them from outer space, they'll look as white areas, because you see all over there is saline water and ice. So that is the main thing you have to remember.
So you see, that's all for today, and in the next video we are going to learn about what are the particular names of different regions and what are the specific characteristics of that particular region. So that's all for today, and we will meet in the next video.